It's finally time. Hi guys, welcome back to The Social Tune, and today we are going to be taking a look at my favorite pop album of 2012, Warrior by Kesha. As I've already stated many times, I've been a big fan of Kesha from the very beginning, but this was the first album to truly showcase just how much talent she really had. A glitchy, electronic, half-auto-tuned, half-clean project, which showcased experimentation, ingenuity, and a love for music that we only saw fragments of on her previous albums. Because of this, I can easily say that Warrior is my favorite Kesha album, a project with an undeniable pop sensibility and a knack for catchy hooks that completely blew me away. So let's not waste any more time, let's dive in. The album starts out with one hell of an anthem. In the same vein as Him and We Are Who We Are, this is a classic anthem for the outsiders, the misfits. The kind of song that encapsulates just why I love so much of her music. Growing up, I was definitely part of that Misfits crowd without being utterly miserable enough to resort to the emo scene. And Warrior is a great example of that, with lines about breaking down doors, pouncing on your ass like a panther, and how it's time for the revolution. It uses metaphors of war and battle to drive the anthemic point home even more strongly than usual. When I first heard this album, I was absolutely sure that this would be my second favorite song on the album. But as the album went on, I was definitely proved wrong. It's not even in my top five. Oh, and I say second favorite because... The big hit from Warrior was really badly marketed, with a music video that was trying way too hard to be controversial and just being dropped at a really bad time. This song never reached the potential that it could have, and yet the song was so great that it could never be entirely denied. And boy do I love it. The song is catchy as hell with a fantastic beat, especially with those thumping drums. And the lyrics kick ass, talking about how she wants to make the most of this night and how she's gonna live like it's her last. And really, despite the obvious parallels, I would say I actually prefer this to DJ Got Us Falling In Love, as it shares all of the same strengths and none of the weaknesses. And you don't quite know the power of this song until you've heard the deconstructed version, which perfectly showcases just how powerful this song is with just a simple change in instrumentation. Let's make the most of the night like we're gonna die. Young hearts out of minds, running till we out of time. Wild child's looking good, living hard just like we should. Absolutely breathtaking and heartbreaking. Great song. You know, for as much as I love Die Young, this is more upbeat, catchier, more danceable. It's just a slice of pop perfection. While Die Young will make my list of the best hit songs of 2012, make no mistake about that, Come On would have had a chance of making my top 50 songs of that year overall. And it's easy to see why, with its dreamy sampled vocals on the verses that creates a fantastic groove, which then bursts into a beautiful bouncing haze on the chorus with Kesha's multi-tracked vocals fitting perfectly over it. And that's before you get to the gorgeous bridge, where the lyrics about taking advantage of the time you have left come into incredibly sharp focus. Absolutely excellent pop song, an easy favorite for me. The first song that isn't bad by any means, but doesn't really blow me away either. Sure, I love the thundering drum and guitar combo, as well as the lyrics where she puts this ex of hers on blast now that she's famous. She really does make it hilarious and cathartic, especially considering this person apparently cheated on her. And I say person because it's left ambiguous whether this is addressing a man or a woman, which is made even more confusing by the references to your boyfriend and telling this person to suck her dick. Neither of which is that unusual for Kesha. I'm just personally not as wild about this chorus as some are, that's all. Still a great song, but she has made better. For instance... I cannot express this strongly enough. Fuck the label and fuck will.i.am for the single version. Crazy Kids is a song in the same vein as Warrior, except better in every way. And the single version, which most people are familiar with, where will.i.am drops one of the worst guest verses I've ever heard, is abysmal. But anyway, the album version is free of him, and thank God for that. The verses will probably remind you of her last albums, just with better structure and writing, while the chorus and bridge are absolutely beautiful while sounding a little desperate, which only serves to make the song even more exciting. Pair that with the fantastic blend of guitar, whistling, and electronic beats, and you have an easy fan favorite for many, including myself. In many ways, this song was kind of ahead of its time. Remember, this came out in 2012, and in 2013, there was a huge burst in popularity for EDM in the charts. And predictably, this is also much better than a lot of that music was, as the drop is much more textured, maintaining a gorgeous melodic foundation throughout its entirety. And the lyrics are just adorable, describing this guy who's always on Kesha's mind, a boy that she used to be deeply in love with, whose memories she'll always cherish, from the nights they've spent together to the love they shared. This wasn't one of my favorites when I first heard it, but every time I've returned to it, I've fallen in love with it a little bit more, and at this point, that love will probably never waver. Hey, remember how Sleazy was an unapologetic and filthy sex song? Well, this is that song on steroids. And the main reason why is a fantastic, grimy rock groove courtesy of rock legend Iggy Pop. Although I will say, for as awesome as Iggy is here, it's Kesha who really shines, as she unapologetically throws herself into this wild debauchery. Her howling on this song is so infectious, she fits over it eerily well. And at this point, there are quite a few songs like this in her catalogue, but this still stands tall as one of the best. Awesome song. Now I wanna do a drive-by, but I can't find the road. Back to Wonderland. So I've said in the past that I love songs about going back to your roots, to the places where you grew up, and reconnecting with old places and friends. It's the main reason I love Castle on the Hill by Ed Sheeran, or Acadia by Marianas Trench. And so, it really shouldn't surprise anyone that this is my favorite song on the whole album. For one, it clearly shows that Kesha needs no assistance from autotune at all, and for another, it's just a profoundly gorgeous track. More than any other song on this album, this one really does live up to its title. It just feels downright magical. And paired with the incredibly descriptive lyrics describing the journey of herself and her friends, as well as the wish to return to that safe place that so many of us can relate to, yeah, there's a reason this is my favorite song off of Warrior, as well as one of my all-time favorite Kesha songs. Okay, for me at least, this falls into a similar place as Thinking of You. And if I had to pick a least favorite song on this album, this would probably be it. Because say what you will about Thinking of You, it's so cathartic and lyrically interesting. And again, this isn't bad, but it's just another song about how she wants to spend the rest of her life with this guy, using the metaphor of dancing to drive the point home. As songs like this go, it is good, but it's just been done better in the past. Not bad, just not her best. So, apparently this song is about having sex with a ghost. Okay. Look, I'm not saying that's not an interesting premise for a song, but frankly, I don't think the song needs that premise to be interesting, as it alternates between a beautiful, ascending melody on the chorus that feels downright transcendent, and a filthy synth-driven groove on the verses where Kesha drops into her more husky tones that also works really well for me. To me, though, this could just merely be a straight-up song about sex. The title doesn't have to be taken literally. Just my opinion, but there it is. And you gotta love the breakdown before the final chorus. There is some great mixing on display here. Great song. I don't remember why, but I always seem to remember hearing this a few weeks before the album dropped. And at the time, it really blew me away. And even now, I can kind of see why. It's upbeat, it's pretty gorgeous, and it has a strident message about living in the moment that I seem to love about a lot of party music. Honestly, while I would say this is a shade weaker than Die Young, it's still a damn great dance track. And the bridge is also absolutely gorgeous, as it conveys a feeling of tension and strange loneliness extremely well, asking you to raise up your phones to prove to Kesha that she's not alone. Well, if my phone weren't in pieces at the moment, I would certainly oblige. Here's the closer to the standard edition of this album, and in a strange twist, it's a song about how the differences between us don't matter. It's basically Kesha's version of Where Is the Love, and frankly, it handles it really, really well. The song is spacious, with a nice build to it, with a ton of echoing atmosphere, while still feeling very much like a Kesha song. Okay, it's not my favorite on the album or anything, but from what most people would expect from Kesha, it really does surprise you. But in a twist that many of you probably already saw coming, I can't talk about Warrior without talking about the four excellent bonus tracks. So, to start us off strong... Why this and Only Want to Dance with You weren't swapped out, I have no idea. The song sounds gorgeous with a simple guitar foundation and echoing multi-tracked vocals. Heck, there's even a ukulele on the bridge. It's a song directed at Kesha's first love, who's moved on and has found another girl. And so, finding it too painful to just be friends, she says goodbye to him once and for all. Some may call it melodramatic, but those who can relate to it know better. Beautiful song. You know, at this point, Kesha has made a lot of songs about not giving a fuck what anyone else thinks. But those songs didn't usually take place in her car, where she's offering this guy to go with her on an American freedom ride. And the details are what really make this song work for me. Like the fact that this guy has a mullet. Or the fact that she wants him to give her a mustache ride, which sounds utterly vile, but hey, you do you. But honestly, the reason this song really works for me is the instrumentation. The banging drums, the rough guitar solo, this is rock and roll as hell. Dirty Love may be great, but this one is something truly special in the most graphic way possible. Fantastic job. Again, talk about being ahead of the curve. Yes, this is yet another example of a fantastic EDM breakdown. And in this case, I can kind of see why this song wasn't included. After all, as controversial as it may be to say that we're all going to die young, it's less controversial than saying no one's getting out alive. But the theme to the song is very similar, except that it's much more blunt about the fact that we're all going to die someday, reminding us that one day you'll run out of air to breathe and gold isn't going to buy you any more time. Which is why we all have to seize the moment and party like tonight is our last. Because after all, it just might be. But I keep on falling for you. Now we get to the real album closer, and for as much as I enjoy Love Into the Light, Past Lives is just a superior song. That's just the way it is. It's a song about finding your true love again and again across time and space. It's literally about being with the one you're destined to be with throughout all the ages. As they end up together time and time again in ancient Egypt, throughout the Crusades, even in the Ice Age. And when the world comes to an end, they'll float together forever as stardust. It's a cosmic song in every way, and it's a gorgeous way to end off this album. Not quite Space Oddity or From Outer Space, but still a damn amazing song all the same. And that was Warrior, an album that truly showcases just how talented Kesha can be when she puts her all in it. And as a whole, it's absolutely excellent, a masterpiece of pop music in every sense. And it's also easily my favorite album of hers, getting an extremely strong 9 out of 10. Damn great work, Kesha. You deserve all the praise you've received for this one, and then some. And sure, the next 5 years of Kesha's life after releasing this would be a huge struggle, but hey, we'll see if it was all worth it next time when we review Rainbow. So stay tuned for that, and otherwise, leave a like if you enjoyed, please subscribe so you don't miss a thing, and until the next time, I'm Finn, and this is The Social Tune, signing off.